and I'm Shima. Welcome back to our YouTube channel. The time flies so fast, right? Due to the COVID-19. We are almost at the end of 2020. Did you realize that? That's very funny. Despite this recent pandemic event, our mud crab farm still operated as usual so that we can maintain our seafood supply chain and meet our customer needs. These few months, especially during the restricted movement control, we did some changes and maintained our farm. So in this video, we will have a quick walk to see the changes in the mud crab farm now. Let's go! Okay, we start with the main system first, which is the sand filter area. As you can see here, we're still using the same sand filter and UV filter over these 3 to 4 years. The sand filter used to remove the big solid waste from the leftover and the mud crab feces. And the UV filter, we use it to kill the bacteria inside the water before it goes back to the crab house. We also added submersible UV light to help the bacteria removal become more efficient. Above the submersible UV light is a protein skimmer. Protein skimmer used to remove the small particle by producing foams. This protein skimmer we construct ourselves, DIY, to meet the requirement and expect to remove the small particles. So ideally, you want 1, to maximize the volume of the bubbles created, 2, minimize the air bubbles created, and 3, increase the retention time of the bubbles spent in the column by the increasing the height of the column. So moving on this side, we have 2 dosing chemical tanks. These 2 tanks mainly dose and increase the alkalinity, magnesium and calcium level in the water. We will measure the water quality every day and we will do an adjustment to meet the recommended level. We add the chemical in the tank and the chemical will dissolve and will be dripped into the system slowly to maintain the optimum water quality requirement in the system. Here we have a small tank where we put our marine seaweed. This seaweed will act as a natural biofilter system and it can treat the phosphate and nitrate inside the water system. So if you want to put add biofilter in your system, you can choose to use any marine seaweed. Here we use Cetamopha algae. This is the area where we do our water quality test. Here we have our schedule, routine and SOP for the water quality and dosing level table. Now let's move on to the crab house. Here we have 10 blocks, namely A, B, C until block J. Here it will have an inlet where the water goes in and outlet pipe. You have to flush out the water to clean the crab house. Let me show you how we do this. You need to pull out the outlet pipe. You can see here we also paint a number for each house. This is done to ease the crab inventory, including the incoming crab, saw crab, the lost crab. By doing this kind of method, you can have systematic inventory control and smooth of the operation. Here we have the retention pond. The water from here will be pumped into the sand filter and going into the biofilter pond. In the biofilter pond, we have a moving media that acts as a surface for the bacteria to grow. This bacteria will help to remove the ammonia produced from the leftover feed, feces and dead crabs. We have to make sure that we have enough aeration and circulation for the media so that the bacteria can work efficiently. This is crucial when you have a high density of crab inside your system so that your crab does not suffocate from the high toxicity of ammonia. Okay, now let's walk to the front area. So this is the new set we have currently. We use this area as a holding area. In this tank, we put the crab that is ready to be sold so we can save the crab house space for the new incoming crab. Interestingly, the setup also makes it a small recirculating system. The water from the holding tank will be pumped into this tank that will be treated with a protein skimmer. And we also include a filter net and stone filter to remove the solid. After that, the water will flow into the biofilter tank. Here you can see the different biofilter media shapes which provide different surface areas for the bacteria. After the water has been treated with biofilter media, the water will flow back into the tank. Here also we have an oxygen cone that we use when we have a high density inside the holding tank. So that's all for our short tour of our mud trap farm. We compiled the necessary information into our ebook. Feel free to download it in the link provided at the description. If you are interested to learn more about this, you can drop us a message or email us and your inquiry. Thank you for watching.